Backstage, it is day number 3 of Rock on the Range, and I'm joined with the guy that kind of opened the show today, Austin from As Lions. Welcome to Rock on the Range.
Oh, thank you ever so much. It's been a pleasure and a privilege. It really has.
Now, let's talk about you guys opening the show. You were the first band on the final day when people are probably their most hungover, their most miserable, not to mention it's raining, and you've got to start at like 11:45.
I think the key is not being hungover or being rained on pre-show.
Right.
I think that was kind of, we had a little bit of an upper hand there. But you know what, man, it was incredible, especially when it's been absolutely just raining this hard and it's been, you know, a bit of a nightmare for everyone, most of all the fans who've come here to hang out and have a great weekend. You know, we knew that we had to just kind of give everyone the show they deserved and make sure that Sunday started right. And it was amazing, you know, like it was absolutely just caning it down with rain before we started. It all stopped. And you know, early morning sets could go either way. There could
right.
be not many people or a lot or none. And then just people just started turning up. There was a ton of them. And yeah, it was amazing. They're absolute troopers, man.
Yeah, I had the chance to come and watch part of the set, and you really got the crowd into it. I mean, like you said, when you're doing an early set like that, you don't know what the crowd's gonna react like, and you really had them kind of eating out of the palm of your hand, getting them involved in the show.
You know what, man? Like, it's one of those things. As long as they're happy, because you know, at the end of the day, they are our boss. So as long as the boss is happy, that's the thing. You know,
right.
You got to make them happy. You got to give them the show, and you just got to wake them up. You know, I think that's. If I was out there in the crowd at Rock on the Range, like I have been at so many other festivals, that is what I would want a band to do, is give me hell or give me nothing. And we like to think we gave them hell today.
I want to talk a little bit about the Nothing More tour you just wrapped up. You did 2 shows in Flint, Michigan at the Machine Shop, which is just south of where we're from in Saginaw. Considered one of the best rock clubs in the country. What was your experience like at the Machine Shop?
Unquestionably. Definitely one of the best, if not the best. Like we had a great time there. Kevin, the owner, is an absolute just diamond dude. Really lovely, as is his whole team. They took great care of us and Nothing More and all the guys. And not only that, but I think that, you know, the people that a place like that attracts, especially the regulars, is great. It's an extension of the ethos they perpetrate. It's a family affair. You turn up and everyone knows everyone, and you just, you know, you give them a show, and it was an honor to play there. So many of my favorite bands have come through it, you know, so.
Whenever people ask me about it and going to see a show there, I always say you can put any band in there and people will show up no matter what because it's the Machine Shop.
I would agree with that. I think that, it was 2 sold-out shows, so I wouldn't really know about the walk-ups, but it was fantastic, man. Nothing More smashed it as well, as did Hell or High Water and Black Bat. They all gave him hell, man. It was really cool.
Now, you've got a debut album, came out fairly recently. You guys have been out on the road supporting it. Tell me a little bit about recording the new album.
Well, we went in initially with David Mendeth, and we did a couple of songs with him, and that whole experience was incredible because he's such an old school guy. There's not really anyone quite like him in the whole world, I think. And he opened our minds to so many possibilities and so many new things that, you know, we did 4 songs with him. Then we went home and we just continued to just write and write and write and write. And then fortunately we couldn't finish the album with him, but we had a guy called Kane Cherko throw his hat in and went, I want to do this. And we're so happy we did, because that guy is like, he lives and breathes music. It's the most fun I've ever had in a studio, because we turned up with all of these insane demos that had so many things we wanted to try. And we also turned up with a bunch more ideas that we wanted to sort of layer on top of that. So it was just lashing out takes, getting the vibe, getting the performance, getting it all down, and just really loving life and feeling really lucky that this is our job. You know, that was kind of the whole atmosphere of the session. I like to kind of think that, you know, when you listen to that record, you can hear genuinely that it's people making that record who have a passion for what they do. You know, Kane included.
And the first single is called Aftermath. It's climbing up the charts, as they say. You're at number 14 right now. And you can tell watching your set today, people recognize the song, which has got to be an awesome feeling.
It's mental, man. Like, coming halfway around the world and seeing people know the words that I wrote at some... It's insane to me. Like, you know, to me, I wrote a song, I love the song, and we put it out. The wonderful thing about music is that once you put it out there, it's not really yours anymore. It's theirs. And they create the story of it. They create what it means, because it means something different to everyone. and they're really in charge of it from that point onwards. So, you know, it's magical to sort of, you know, meet people that have heard it and have kind of made it their own. You know, that's like the biggest compliment we can possibly be paid.
As you got into the music industry, for those that don't know, your dad is Bruce Dickinson from Iron Maiden. What kind of advice has he given you in terms of writing, recording, touring, just the music business in general?
Don't screw up.
Simple, three words. I think that can apply to basically anything that you do.
Pretty much. I think that, you know, if you're going to do something, do it right. You know, that's why we will never tour with them until we are an asset to the bill and until we've earned our place on that bill. Same thing goes for Metallica, Avenged, any other gigantic monolithic band that we may endeavor to tour with. You know, we're far too busy kind of building our own profile, building our own vibe, building our own little empire, man. That's us.
And I think you're doing it the right way, because I think there is a lot of people that probably would expect you to maybe try and, quote, ride the coattails, and you're not doing that at all. You're playing the early set at Rock on the Range. You're paying your dues, as they say.
Absolutely, man. I think that these are the kind of things that matter, because once you actually experience success, you'll know what it's truly worth.
Right. Now, what's the plan after, I know you just wrapped up the tour with Nothing More, what's next for As Lions?
After this, we go home on the day after tomorrow, and we have got Rock Am Ring, Rock in Park in Germany, and we've got Nova Rock, which is in Austria, and we've got Graspop in Belgium, and we've got a September headline tour of the United Kingdom. And we've got a bunch of other cool stuff that we can't really say just yet, but it's pretty amazing.
So make sure you check out the website, check out the social media, get out and see As Lions. Awesome set today, and go enjoy the rest of your day.
Thank you ever so much, friend. My friend.
Thank you, man.
I forgot how to speak English.
That's all right. It happens.